What to Play presents 25 of the best two-player games on the PlayStation 4, all arranged by play scores. To check out our full list, visit our website at whattoplay.com. You can also take part in our rankings by leaving reviews of the games that you played. This video is sponsored by Code Atma, a free-to-play mobile supernatural RPG. More about them later in the video. Number 25, Untitled Goose Game. We start off our list with a game we're all too familiar with. If you want to ruin someone's day as an annoying goose, what better way to do it than with a partner? Grab an extra controller and enjoy messing around the game world in local co-op. Unfortunately, there's no split screen, so you'll have to share one screen together. The price to pay for chaos, I guess. A play score of 8.34. At 24, Legend of Mana. Square Enix's beloved JRPG fares better when played alone, like all great JRPG experiences. However, when everything starts getting frustrating or grindy, calling a friend is a nice option to have. Hand your friend another controller and have them join you in the journey to find that mystical mana tree. A play score of 8.34. At 23, Trine 2, Complete Story. Trine's side-scrolling adventure welcomes more than just one player. Work together with a friend in its local and online co-op multiplayer. You can play with up to two players and solve a variety of challenging puzzles together. A play score of 8.36.
Zenpai, Sentou Junbi.
Wari, ore, shinda. Yappa ikiteta. Mouke.
At 22nd place, One Piece, Pirate Warriors 3. Friendship and teamwork are necessary for every shonen anime, and this critically acclaimed video game adaptation of Eiichiro Oda's masterpiece knows what's up. Pirate Warriors 3 lets you team up with a friend in almost all missions. Select from a wide variety of iconic One Piece characters and duke it out in epic high seas action. A play score of 8.36. Door Kickers Action Squad. Local or online, grab a friend and take the role of SWAT agents in charge of kicking doors down. Together with your cop buddy, strategize your way around its tricky side-scrolling levels, bust up bad guys, and show them the true meaning of justice. A play score of 8.36. At 20, Samurai Warriors 5. If you're into Koei Tecmo's Dynasty Warriors series, then you'll enjoy the Samurai spin-off with its fluid hack-and-slash action. A reboot of the classic series, you can partner with a friend in local and online co-op and go all out slicing and dicing enemies in Sengoku-era Japan. A play score of 8.37. At 19, Skylanders Trap Team. A classic from the bygone days of the last-gen consoles, this kid-friendly 3D platformer uses Skylander figurines to completely amp up your experience. In Trap Team, you can hand out the extra controller to your friend and go on epic fantasy adventures together. A play score of 8.38. 18. Knights and Bikes. Whether you want to go on your journey on foot or on a bike, this is a journey you shouldn't do alone. Play as Nessa and Demelza and save this island from ruin. Limited to only two players, go online or local and partake in dungeon crawling quests with your growing party. A play score of 8.39. At 17, LEGO Dimensions. It's not a LEGO game when you're not playing with someone. Explore the multiverse of multi-million dollar franchises with a friend in its drop-in, drop-out, two-player co-op. Like all LEGO titles, build LEGO blocks out of nowhere and solve a variety of puzzles. A play score of 8.46. At 16, Children of Morta. A strong co-op title brandishing that signature roguelike flair, Children of Morta demands you to play the game again and again to learn more about its story and characters. The Bergsons are a family, but it doesn't hurt to take help from a friend. With just an extra controller, you can navigate around its challenging dungeons with ease. A play score of 8.52. Arise, A Simple Story. An emotional roller coaster that deals with grief and time. As we all know, misery loves company. It opens up an opportunity for local cooperative play, so you and your extra hand can share tissues and cry together. In this journey, one player controls the protagonist and the other controls the flow of time. Work hand in hand. A play score of 8.56. At 14, Crypt of the Necro Dancer. Rhythm games and the creativity of indie developers make a great combination. Necro Dancer's rhythmic dungeon crawling adventures are a daunting task to do alone. If you have an extra controller, you can call a buddy and work together as you move and groove to the never-ending music and couch co-op goodness. A play score of 8.57. Before we get to the next game on our list, we'd like to thank the Agate team, the proud developers behind Code Atma, for once again sponsoring this week's videos. Their game has finally been released to a worldwide audience. Code Atma will take you to a unique world that is unlike any other RPG out there. The world is so vast and immersive that you'll definitely enjoy exploring and trying out their different mechanics. Grinding has been an annoying part of RPG gaming, but not here. It's all about strategies in Code Atma. Every Atma is not only beautifully designed, but they all have their individual backstories and lore. Place them where they are the strongest and rise in the ranks. Going on now until November 3rd, Code Atma is celebrating the spooktacular time of the year with loads of tricks and treats. From limited cosmetics to various limited time events, there's lots to do this Halloween. Come join the fun, download Code Atma now on iOS and Android with our links in the description below. And don't forget to use Code Atma X What to Play for special in-game items. At 13, Cat Quest 2. The open-world action RPG leans towards the adorable. Play cats and dogs in this two-player co-op and explore the magical open-world kingdom. Dive into dungeons and take down monsters for loot in a cat venture like never before. It receives a play score of 8.58. At 12th place, Nuclear Throne. Vlambeer's top-down shooter is a prime example of life finds a way, packed in a hilariously grotesque experience. In a world where humanity no longer exists, mutated limbs and radioactive waste are an everyday sight. Two players can work together to survive the post-apocalyptic wasteland and become the kings of their domain. A play score of 8.63. At 11, Cuphead. One of 2017's most visually impressive titles, Studio MDHR's run-and-gun platformer takes from cartoons of the 1930s and uses them to set the mood for its fast-paced, bullet-hell action. Cuphead's buddy Mugman will join you in your adventure as you smack your way into gorgeously animated bosses. A play score of 8.63. At 10, Rezogun. Before Returnal, Housemarque's projects were centered on fast-paced shoot-em-ups. Rezogun entered the PS4 as an exclusive, earning themselves the right to enter Sony's Hall of Fame. In this sci-fi trip, two players team up to complete levels and compare high scores. A play score of 8.69. At 9, Hyper Light Drifter. The purple-soaked dimension of Devolver Digital's action-adventure is oozing with atmosphere. Co-op in this game is different from the rest of the titles here. Your partner takes the role of a ghost, a clone of the main character, and both of you can navigate the same world together. You can revive them if they die, fight other monsters, and so much more. A play score of 8.69. 8. Sonic Mania Plus. A retro revival to Sega's critically acclaimed Sonic entry, the multiplayer aspect drags up to 4 players in competition mode. But its co-op is another story. Like the vanilla Sonic Mania, you can invite a friend over to a local two-player co-op where they play as Tails and you as Sonic. Together, you take down Dr. Eggman and blaze across levels. A play score of 8.70. At 7, The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Excluding the Afterbirth DLC where you can play up to 3 players, the vanilla version of Rebirth can only let you play with 1 player in local co-op. The premise remains the same. You explore this demented dungeon and use tears as bullets. Also, you share the same health bar and items, so good luck! A play score of 8.72. At 6, Enter the Gungeon. Devolver Digital's sanctuary of Easter eggs, pop culture references, and a crap ton of firepower, the Gungeon shenanigans are best experienced with a partner in local co-op. Together, survive the relentless hordes of the Gundead, and find the gun that can kill the past. It receives a play score of 8.72. At 5th place, Hunt Down. This side-scrolling retro shooter takes us back to the good old days of 80s gaming. Hunt Down takes pride in its inspirations from retro classics like Contra and Metal Slug, adding its own unique and modern twist. Of course, games like these are often better with an extra hand, so take a friend along for the ride and enjoy blasting. A play score of 8.76. At 4th place, Salt and Sanctuary. This 2D adventure from Ska Studios can scratch your souls-like itch. Its local co-op allows players to drop in and act as a cell sword that can aid the main player's journey. While it's far from From Software's acclaimed series, Salt and Sanctuary stands on its own ground with its distinct art style and fluid combat. A play score of 8.79. At 3rd place, Nex Machina. Another project from Housemark, and as usual, it's a twin-stick shooter reminiscent of the days of classic arcade gaming. What sets it apart from its inspirations is its vibrant colors and modern visuals. Inviting a friend over for a local two-player co-op enables you to fight side by side. A play score of 8.95.
All right, you want to give it a try?
We haven't got time for this.
Oh, are you afraid of losing?
Me? Huh, no way. Bring it on.
Oh, I'm going to bring it.
At 2nd place, It Takes Two. It's in the name. Of all the titles on this list, this EA original is impossible to play alone. So invite your significant other, best friend, or whoever is closest to you right now. Enjoy a wild ride of varied gameplay moments that are best experienced blind. A play score of 9.05. And at 1st place, Divinity Original Sin 2 Definitive Edition. The ultimate co-op experience for hardcore RPG fans, this is Larian Studios' strongest work to date. If you want to invite more than just one friend, you're free to do so. The world of Original Sin 2 is brimming with lore and stuff to do. You can spend hours and hours exploring and dungeon crawling with your friends in local and online co-op. A play score of 9.08.